हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स। वेलकम बैक इन योर मैथ्स क्लास, क्लास फिफ्थ, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। दिस इज आवर चैप्टर 5, फ्रैक्शंस, एंड इट इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 2। टुडे सब टॉपिक्स आर एक्सरसाइज 5A, वी विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 ए टू डी पार्ट, इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 ए टू आई पार्ट, क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, 8 एंड 9th क्वेश्चन ए एंड बी पार्ट्स वी विल डू। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आवर एक्सरसाइज 5A। क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, रिड्यूस द फॉलोइंग फ्रैक्शंस टू द लोएस्ट टर्म्स और इट कैन बी लोएस्ट फॉर्म्स। ए पार्ट इज देयर 5/45। वी नो दैट दिस बोथ द नंबर्स आर डिविजिबल बाय 5, सो वी हैव टू स्टार्ट द डिविजन विद दैट नंबर। We have to take that number which will divide both numerator as well as denominator. Lowest term मतलब छोटी form में करना, जो number given है उसको small करना. So 5 and 45 both are divisible with 5. So we will divide this numerator divided by 5, denominator divided by 5. 5 divide 5, our quotient is 1. 45 divide 5, quotient will be 9. Now 1/9, no further division is possible, so 5/45 is reduced to 1/9. Clear? We have to select that number which will divide numerator and denominator together. This is our second method for converting into lowest term. 5/45 we have taken again that first part. We will find out the SCF of 5 and 45. SCF, now you all know how to find out. Okay, so SCF of 5 and 45 is 5, because 5 9s are 45, so last divisor is 5, so SCF is 5. Now we will divide the given fraction with its HCF. 5 divide HCF, 45 divide by SCF, so after division we will get 1/9. It is your wish, you can take method 1 or you can take method 2. Now, fifth question, B part. 11/44. We have to reduce this into lowest term. Now, 11/44. We know that these both the numbers, numerator and denominator, both are divisible by 11. So, 11 divide 11 and 44 divide by 11. 11 divide 11 will give you the quotient 1. 44 divide by 11 give you the quotient 4. 1/4. No further division is possible. So 11/44 is reduced to 1/4. What we have done in this method? We have seen the numbers which are written as a numerator and as a denominator. That 11 and 44, these both are coming in the table of 11. So we have done division with 11. And our second method says that you have to find out the SCF of 11 and 44. You know that if you are finding out the SCF of 11 and 44, that is also 11. Then you will divide with SCF. So you can take any method. Answer will be same for both. Now our C part, 27/36. Now we know that this both the terms, 27 and 36, both are divisible with 9, divisible with 3. You know this? Okay. So we have started it dividing with 9. 27 divided by 9. 36 divided by 9. So 9 3s are 27. 9 4s are 36. So our fraction 27/36 will become 3/4. Now 3 and 4. We can say that these are 3 is odd number, 4 is even number, and no common factor is here. So no further division is possible. So 27/36 is reduced to 3/4. Okay. Otherwise also, if you are finding out the SCF of 27 and 36, SCF is 9. Then we will divide with SCF. And one more thing is there, beta, if you have started dividing it with 3, that is also okay. Agar aap 3 se divide karte hain, then further one more step you will divide with 3. I will take one question of like this also. Okay. Now let's do D part. 54 upon 72. We have to reduce it to the lowest form. 54 and 72 both are even number, divisible by 2. So we will divide by 2 and we will get 27 upon 36. 27 and 36 both are divisible by 3. So we will divide it by 3 and we will get 9 upon 12. 9 upon 12 divided by 3 and we will get 3 upon 4. Now no further division is possible. So 54 upon 72 is reduced to 3 upon 4. Now our question number 6. It is given in your book. Insert greater, less or equal signs in the boxes. A part 3 upon 9, 2 upon 9. See, but the denominators are same. And when denominators are same, then the fraction whose numerator is greater will be the greater fraction. So 3 upon 9 is greater than 2 upon 9. 4 upon 6, 4 upon 7. Now, numerators are same. As the numerators are same, so the fractional number whose denominator is smaller will be the greater fraction. So, 4 upon 6, 4 upon 7. 4 upon 6 is greater because its denominator is 6, smaller number. Now, 3 upon 7, 5 upon 7. So, greater is 5 upon 7. As denominators are same, so we will check numerators. Greater numerator will be the greater fraction. 1 upon 2, 2 upon 4. Here we know that 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So both the sides 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So equal sign will be here. Right? Next is 1, 1 by 7. 1, it is a whole number. And 1 by 7, it is a fractional part. So whole number is greater. 1 will be greater. Now 3 upon 6, 1 upon 2. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. So now this fraction is changed into 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 2. So equal sign will be there in the box. Right? Next is our question number 7. Circle the greatest fraction in each. A part 2 upon 5, 1 upon 5, 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5. Denominators are same. Like fractions are given. So, we have to check the numerator. The fraction whose numerator is greater will become the greatest fraction. So, the greatest fraction will be 4 upon 5. B part 4 upon 6, 5 upon 6, 3 upon 6, 1 upon 6. So, greatest fraction is 5 upon 6. C part 8 upon 10, 1 upon 10, 4 upon 10, 3 upon 10. Denominators are same. Like fractions are there. So, we will check the numerators. 8 is there. So, 8 upon 10 is the greatest fraction. Now, our question number 8. Circle the smallest fraction in each. Now, we have to circle the smallest fraction. 1 upon 13. A part is there. 1 upon 13. 6 upon 13. 7 upon 13. 8 upon 13. Again, like fractions are these. Denominators are same. So, we will check the numerator. The fraction whose numerator is smaller will become the smallest fraction. So, 1, 6, 7, 8. The smallest is 1. Smallest fraction will become 1 upon 13. Now, B part. 1 upon 8, 3 upon 8, 2 upon 8, 4 upon 8. Denominators are same. 8, 8, 8 and 8. So we will check numerators. Numerators are 1, 3, 2, 4. 1 is a smaller numerator. So smallest fraction is 1 upon 8. Understood? Very good. You have done in previous class also. Okay? So you have to revise carefully now. C part. 4 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7, 1 upon 7. Denominators are same. These are like fractions. So we will check numerators. 4, 2, 3 and 1. The smaller numerator is 1. So the smallest fraction is 1 upon 7. 1 upon 7. Clear? Now before starting our next question, question number 9. You have to tell me first, do you know the meaning of ascending order and descending order? Yes, we have done also now in previous chapters. Okay, then tell me ascending order. Ascending order means smaller to greater. In Hindi we will say badhte kram mein, chote se bada likhna. And descending order means bigger to smaller, bade se chote mein likhna. घटते क्रम में. Understood? Because our ninth question is based on ascending order. Okay? In previous chapters, we have done ascending and descending order for the whole numbers. Now we will do ascending order and descending order for our fractional numbers. Okay? So, keep the thing in the mind. Whatever is explained in the previous chapters, these will be used in the next chapters also. Question number 9. Arrange the following in ascending order. A part 1 upon 6, 1 upon 9, 1 upon 8. We know that beta ascending order means smaller to greater. Badhte kram mein. So write down the question again. 1 upon 6, 1 upon 9, 1 upon 8. When numerator is same. We have said that numerator is same. So, when numerator is same, then the fractional number that has the greater denominator is the smaller fraction. Right? So, see that 6, 9 and 8 are the denominators. So, greater denominator is 9. So, the fraction 1 upon 9 will become smaller. Understood? Then after 9 there is 8. So the fraction 1 upon 8 will be the second fraction in our ascending order. And then last will be 1 upon 6. So we will write down 1 upon 9 is smaller than 1 upon 8. And 1 upon 8 is smaller than 1 upon 6. So we will write down at last. So ascending order is equal to 1 upon 9. Is smaller than 1 upon 8 and 1 upon 8 is smaller than 1 upon 6. Now, ninth question, B part. 3 upon 4, 1 upon 4, 2 upon 4. Now see, denominators are same. When the denominator is same, then the fraction that has a smaller numerator is smaller. So, we have to check the numerators now. Numerators are 3, 1 and 2. So, the smaller numerator is 1, next is 2 and next is 3. So, our fraction will become 1 upon 4 is smaller than 2 upon 4 and 2 upon 4 is smaller than 3 upon 4. So, ascending order is equal to 1 upon 4 is smaller than 2 upon 4 is smaller than 3 upon 4. Now, it's time to take homework. Your homework is solve question 3 A to E parts of Let's Rewind exercise in notebook and learn table of 16. I hope you all have the books now. If you don't have book, then you can see the questions on the adquark.com website. There also I am uploading the questions. Now we will do homework discussion of lecture 1. Have you done your homework? Yes? Okay, then take out your practice notebooks. Take out your pen. You will check your answers. If any answer will be wrong, then you will do correction work. Question 1 and 2 were given from your Let's Rewind exercise. So, this is your chapter 5 fractions. Let's Rewind exercise. Our question number 1 is, write each of the following as fractions. You have to write down these in the form of fraction. A fraction is a part of the whole which is written in the form of numerator divided by denominator. So, our A part is divided by 9, so it is written as 2 upon 9. 13 divided by 17, so it will become 13 upon 17. 21 divided by 23, so it will become in fractional form 21 upon 23. 1 divided by 19, fraction will be 1 upon 19. 19 divided by 31, so its fractional form is 19 upon 31. And now f part, 44 divided by 71 is equal to 44 upon 71. Question number 2, write as mixed numbers or mixed fractions. A part, 3 upon 2, so 3 will be divided by 2, 2 ones are 2, 1 will be remainder. So our mixed fraction form is Q whole R upon D. So 3 upon 2 will become 1 whole 1 upon 2. Q is a quotient. 1 is remainder and 2 is D divisor. Understood? B part, 15 upon 4. So 15 divided by 4. 4 threes are 12. After subtraction you will get remainder 3. So 15 upon 4 is equal to 3 whole 3 upon 4. Right? Now question number 2. Write as mixed numbers. C part, 21 upon 5. 21 will be divided by 5. 5 fours are 20. 21 minus 20, we will get 1 as a remainder. So 21 upon 5 is equal to Q whole R upon D. 4 whole 1 upon 5. This is a mixed fraction form. Now D part, 43 upon 7. 43 will become dividend, 7 divisor. 7 6 are 42. Now 3 minus 2 1, 4 minus 4 0. So 6 will become quotient, 1 will become remainder. So 43 upon 7 is equal to 6 whole 1 upon 7. E part, 54 upon 7. 54 divided by 7. 7 7s are 49. 54 minus 49, remainder is 5. So mixed fraction is 7 whole 5 upon 7. And now our F part, 42 upon 8. This is the question, 42 upon 8. We know that 42 and 8 both are divisible by 2. So we have done division first. 42 divided by 2, 21. 8 divided by 2, 4. Now 21 divided by 4. 4 5s are 20. 21 minus 21. So 42 upon 8. First of all, it is changed into 21 upon 4. Then its fractional form is mixed fraction form, 5 whole 1 upon 4. Beta, if you have forgot to do cutting here in the starting, then definitely your answer will be there 5 whole 2 upon 8. Then do cutting here, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. Okay, then answer will become 5 whole 1 by 4. These were our homework questions. Tell me one thing, are you revising the tables? Yes, very good. Always you have to revise at least one or two tables daily. Okay? Kindly like our videos and subscribe our channel. Thank you.